Sleep essentially builds our brains to work best in the environment that we live in. We sample the world from the day we're born, and every night our brains get reprogrammed, and sleep is the most efficient state by which that happens. It's like getting software updates for our brains. So we sample the world, we experience many things that we are conscious of, like when we learn new things in school, but also lots of things we're not conscious of. And what happens every night is our brain is basically incorporating all that experience, conscious and subconscious. Bits of the brain talk to each other. So it's like every morning we wake up physically and mentally a different person. It's a really simple explanation why we sleep, and actually teasing that apart, getting to the core of the matter, and then when you build up to understanding why it is that we and other living things sleep, you can really see why understanding and prioritizing sleep as much as nutrition and being active in life is really important for health, and in particular mental health. There is no neuropsychiatric or neurodegenerative disorder that I'm aware of that doesn't have a sleep abnormality associated with it. Likewise, mood disorders. Is the sleep problem a product of the neuropsychiatric or neurodegenerative disease, or in some cases a cause? So actually prioritizing optimal sleep may be a very beneficial way to mitigate or help reduce some of the mental health concerns we have with an active society that's 24/7. Versus, and perhaps in some instances, replacing the need for an enormous amount of drugs that are given to people and they don't always work.